Dear brothers and sisters, beloved Muslims, today inshallah we'll talk about this place, the place in which we gather. It is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You may have witnessed, and I may have witnessed, some violations for the etiquettes of this house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is my primary responsibility to remind and educate so that we understand the virtue and the position of this place in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and try to help one another in observing the etiquettes that is due for the Masajidullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These Masajid belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are the dearest places to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. Indeed, Masajid belong to Allah. They are built for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and therefore do not worship anyone beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brothers and sisters, if one of us visited and became a guest of a noble person, of a generous leader, one would necessarily expect to be honored and to be dealt with generosity and grace. Imagine the reward that is in being a guest in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the most generous and who is the most gracious subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in the hadith, which was recorded by Bukhari and Muslim, that man ghada ila al-masjidi aw raha a'adda Allah lahu nuzulan fil jannati kullama ghada aw raha. Whoever comes in the masjid, to the masjid in the morning or the evening, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will prepare for him in every time he comes in the morning or evening whatever the host prepares for his guest. And again, the only way we can appreciate this promise that is included in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is when we remember that we are dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most generous. And one of those things with which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will honor his guests is when he allows them to feel the beauty and the sweetness of his worship, and boost their iman and belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the seal of iman is given to every person who maintains visiting the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and this is a shahada, this is a testimony from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for every visitor of the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إنما يعمر مساجد الله من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر. Indeed, those who maintain the masajid of Allah, maintain visiting the masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the last day. Dear brothers and sisters, on the day of reckoning, on the day of judgment, the day that is filled with petrifying scenes, those people whose hearts are attached with this place, with the masjid, will be secure, will be sheltered under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the shade of the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when there is no shade that would protect the person from the heat, from the fierce heat of that day, but the shade of the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, which was recorded by Bukhari and Muslim, سَبْعَةٌ يُظِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّهُ وَعَدَّ مِنْهُمْ وَرَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسَاجِدِ. Seven types of people will be sheltered under the shade of the throne of Allah on the day of resurrection. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam listed these people, and one type is a person whose heart is attached to the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The masjid is a refuge, a resort. We resort to the masjid. We take refuge in the masjid. We, in the face of the troubles, in the face of the worries, in the face of the heavy load and the burdens of this materialistic life, one finds in the masjid a refuge. He comes to participate in a gathering where people are reciting the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or benefit from a reminder that is given, or learn something about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or His Messenger, or learn something about the commands of Allah and the commands of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, clarifying for him the straight path, as-sirat al-mustaqim, and benefiting from the fruits of such gathering, as Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَمَجْتَمَعَ قَوْمٌ فِي بَيْتٍ مِّنْ بِيُوتِ اللَّهِ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَيَتَدَارَسُونَهُ بَيْنَهُمْ إِلَّا نَزِلَتْ عَلَيْهِمُ السَّكِينَةُ وَغَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمَةُ وَحَفَّتْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَذَكَرَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنْ عِنْدَ ذَلِكَ. Whenever people gather reading the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and exerting effort to understand the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tranquility descend upon them, and the angels surround them, and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be showered upon them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make mention of them before the angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention that so and so and so and so and so and so before the angels are gathering to read the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and trying to understand the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brothers and sisters, masajid are special places. They are not like any other place. Rather, they are places of sanctity, and therefore we have to have the respect that it do the masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have to appreciate them and value them and honor them and respect them, because honoring them is part of honoring Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذَلِكَ وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. Whoever honors the worship rites of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is indeed a sign of the piety of the heart. Therefore, dear brothers and sisters, number one, we have to love these places because they are the dearest places to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and appreciate them, and remember that these are the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, about which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فِي بِيُوتٍ أَذِنَ اللَّهُ أَن تُرْفَعَ وَيُذْكَرَ فِيهَا اسْمُهُ يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ فِيهَا بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْآصَالِ رِجَالٌ لَا تُلِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ وَلَا بَيْعٌ عَن ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. In houses that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has permitted that it be raised, and that His name be praised by people who exalt in the morning and the evening, and they glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the morning and the evening. يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ فِيهَا بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْآصَالِ رِجَالٌ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describe these people, رِجَالٌ لَا تُلْهِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ وَلَا بَيْعٌ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. People who neither commerce nor business transaction distract them from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What drives them is the fear from Allah, the fear of the day of judgment, the fear of a day تَتَقَلَّبُ فِيهِ الْقُلُوبُ الْأَبْصَارِ, the hearts, a day on which the hearts and the eyeballs will be overturned because of the fear of that day. This which drives them to come and glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be focused upon purpose of life, because لا تلهيهم تجارة ولا بيع عن ذكر الله. Allah here is endorsing people's engagement in business and transaction with one condition, that this business and this commerce do not divert the person from the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brothers and sisters, this is, so number one, is to understand that this is the house of Allah and to love it. And to know that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Al-Masjidu Baytu Kulli Taqi. Masjid is the house of every righteous person, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guaranteed for the person who make the masjid his house, his own house, بِالْرَوْحِ وَالْرَحْمَةِ وَالْجَوَازِ عَلَى الصِّرَاطِ إِلَى رِضْوَانِ اللَّهِ إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. That Allah will guarantee for him, for the person who makes this house his house, will guarantee for him happiness, joy, and rahmah, mercy, and passage, safe passage to the pleasure of Allah and to paradise. Dear brothers and sisters, another duty that is required from us towards the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to maintain it. We built it, but we should not neglect it. Rather, we built it, we maintain it, we keep it clean, we make it smell good. And this is something that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has instructed us to do, to always clean the house, because the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because this is the house in which the most pure acts are performed, that is as-salah, qira'atul Quran, reciting the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dhikrullah, and majalisul ilm, and many other acts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved. So it must be maintained, it must be cleaned. We should not build it and neglect it, even though building the masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a great note in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من بنى لله بيتا كمفحص قطات لبيضها بنى الله له بيتا في الجنة. Whoever builds a house as small as the little house that a bird built in order to house its eggs in it, the eggs in it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will build for him a house in paradise. Dear brothers and sisters, and therefore there are certain etiquettes, there are certain rules that we must observe in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That these etiquettes start before entering the house of Allah, because we should be prepared that we are entering to the house of Allah, and it is best that a person perform his wudu and be upon a complete state of purity, tahara, before one comes to the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because there is a special reward in that. One should be ready by being on the state of tahara, by wearing the best type of clothing, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا بَنِي آدَمْ خُذُوا زِينَتَكُمْ عِنْدَ كُلِّ مَسْجِدٍ. All descendants of Adam, adorn yourselves, beautify yourselves, be your best when you enter to the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, من تطهر في بيته ثم مضى إلى بيت من بيوت الله ليقضي فريضة من فرائض الله كانت خطواته إحداها تحط خطيئة والأخرى ترفع درجة. Imam Muslim recorded that whoever perform wudu and become ready for prayer, be pure, ready to stand in prayer, and then he head towards one of the houses of Allah to perform a fariyadah. Every step that he takes, it lifts him one rank in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and will wipe away one sin from him. So this is something that is virtuous among part of the etiquette of the masjid, that when we enter to the masjid, we enter by our right foot, and we say Bismillah, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, Allahumma iftah li abwaba rahmati, in the name of Allah, O Allah, make salah upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, open for me the gates of your mercy. We are entering to the house of Allah, and it is conducive to have this supplication, to attain the purpose of visiting the Masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that is to be graced by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then one says, أعوذ بالله العظيم وبوجهه الكريم وسلطانه القديم من الشيطان الرجيم. Seeking a refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the accursed devil, because when we come to the masjid, we are doing something that is most beneficial to ourselves. And at this point, the shaitan is most enraged, and therefore he tries his best to divert us from this process, purpose, to minimize this benefit by any way, shape, or form. And therefore, we seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the shaitan. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever enters to one of the houses of Allah and seek refuge from Allah in Allah from the accursed devil, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect him from the devil throughout the day. What a beautiful reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we go out, we go by our left hand, the left foot, exactly opposite to entering to the bathroom. Because the bathroom is a place of dirt, and the masjid is a place of purity and of cleanliness, and therefore we forward our right foot when we enter to the masjid, and we forward our left foot when we leave from the masjid. And we say, invoke Allah, Bismillah, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, Allahumma aftah li abwaab fadlik. In the name of Allah, Allah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give salah upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Oh Allah, open for me the gates of your bounties. And then he says, Allahumma asubni min ash-shaytan. You also seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the shaytan. One of the etiquettes of entering to the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to start by saying two rak'ah, by praying two rak'ah. Even if you come in the middle of a khutbah in Salatul Jum'ah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam once saw a person coming and sitting without performing two rak'ah, and he commanded him to stand and pray two rak'ah. This two rak'ah called Tahiyyatul Masjid, and according to some of the scholars, it is an obligation, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith which was recorded by Bukhari and Muslim, إِذَا دَخَلَ أَحَدُكُمُ الْمَسْجِدْ فَلَا يَجْلِسْ حَتَّى يُصَلِّي رَكْعَتَيْنِ. When one of you enters the masjid, let him not sit until he pray two rak'ah. So pray rak'ah. The only difference in Salatul Jum'ah, if you are to enter while the khatib is while the speaker is already in the khutbah, in the service, then in this case you make two right rak'ah. You don't pray Surah Al-Baqarah or Ali Imran in these two rak'ah. Rather, they are light, so that you benefit from the sermon of the khatib. One of the most important things when it comes to the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we should make sure that it is clean from najasat. It is clean from najasat, it's purified. Okay, there is no najasa in them. As you know, that one time a man came and urinated in the middle of the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you know, this is the beauty of Islam. Islam, not to urinate in the middle of the masjid of the Taqiyyah. Rather, the beauty of Islam, it came to refine our character. And therefore, if we come from back home with a lot of traditions that is in violation of Islam, or we come with manners that contradict the spirit of Islam, we should be open to learn the etiquettes of Islam, so that that our character be refined. So this man came like any Bedouin. He does not know any etiquettes or any thing better. and urinated in the middle of the masjid. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of course the Sahaba were about to hurt him, but Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, leave him, do not interfere with him, interrupt his urinification, rather pour a bucket of water upon it. And then he said, teaching that man and the Sahaba radiallahu anhu and the Ummah until the Day of Judgment, he said, in هذه المساجد لا يصلح لا تصلح لشيء من هذا البول ولا القذر إنما هي لذكر الله والصلاة وقراءة القرآن. He said, and again this is defining the function of the masjid, like in the first ayah that we recited, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال رجال. So it is for the tasbih, for ذكر الله عز وجل. And here Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said that these are the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So none of this filth is conducive or befit this pure place, the masjid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rather, masajid of Allah are for dhikrullah and salah and qira'atu. Among the etiquettes of the masajid, dear brothers and sisters, is to avoid eating something that has a bad odor before coming to the masjid, like eating garlic or onion or radish or anything that fall under this category, because Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man akala thuman aw basalan falyatizilna aw falyatizil masjidana. Bukhari and Muslim recorded that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever eats garlic or onion, let him stay away from our masjid. And in another hadith he clarified for us the reasoning from this, that لِأَنَّ الْمَلَائِكَةَ تَتَأَذَّى مِمَّا يَتَأَذَّى بِهِ بَنُوا آدَمَ, because the angels are harmed by whatever harms human beings. So number one, if we do that, we are harming the fellow musalli that is standing beside us, foot to foot and shoulder to shoulder and smell to smell. This is a problem if there is a bad smell, and therefore we need to be careful. We need to clear ourselves from all these types of food that causes bad odor. And one of the things that falls in the same category is smoking, dear brothers and sisters. Those of us who smoke, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inshaAllah help us to quit this bad habit. This is a bad habit that all of us, nobody, even those who smoke, I never saw a smoker who say that smoking is a good habit. So all of us agree, smokers and non-smokers, that this is a bad habit. However, when we come to the masjid, we need to make a special effort to come with a good odor. Okay, we wear some perfume before we come, and this is specific for our brothers, because women are prohibited from wearing a perfume when they go in the public. So this is something to keep in mind. One more etiquette or concerning the masajid is that if somebody loses something, one is not allowed to stand and publicly announce that. It is also prohibited to make a business transaction in the masjid, like selling and buying transaction. And the reason the scholar said is that it all falls under raising your voice and interfering with the worship of the praying people, of the people who are reading the Quran or engaging in some kind of zikr. So raising voices is not allowed, not permitted in Islam. And therefore Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that we should tell the person who is announcing about a lost item that لا رد الله عليك ضالتك. May you never find this. Why? Because you are interfering with the purpose of this place. This place is not for announcement, for all these things. Rather, it is for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also another thing falls under this category is the cell phone. This is cell phone is one of the bounties of this of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during this time, but it could be a curse too. It could be a curse when we don't when we are not sensitive toward our surroundings and toward the place in which we are. Imagine people are just standing by the grave and just listening to a reminding from the person who is burying that person, and all of a sudden this silence, this weeping, just in heeding the reminder will be interrupted by rock and roll music from ourselves. Why? Because we are not sensitive to this. We have, at the moment that we enter to the masjid, we have to cut off our relationship with the outside, especially when we are attending an obligation. This is an obligation, like Salatul Jum'ah is an obligation, and therefore you cut off your cell phone and turn it off, and just to be on the safe side, you always put a normal ringing tone, not just something that is not conducive to an atmosphere of the masjid. This is becoming very embarrassing here, brothers and sisters, and therefore we need to pay close attention to our actions in the masjid. Nowadays we can do our business while we are sitting in the masjid. We can text message, we can email while you are sitting in the prayer. And this is again violate the very spirit of attending the masjid. Nobody is putting a gun on your head and forcing you to come to the masjid. However, when you come, then make sure that you help yourself and you help others in maintaining the purpose of the being in the masjid, and that is to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I've witnessed something that may lead to a dispute between the believers when they are attending the salah, like somebody who start talking on his cell phone during the Jum'ah, and in some cases one brother just shouted at him, sit down first, and people divided, one supporting the person who is shouting, and one is censuring the style in which that person is forbidding or reminding his brother that you should turn off your cell phone. So this is a potential situation for dispute, and therefore we need to again be sensitive toward the place in which we are. This is a masjid. The masjid is a clean, quiet place, and we should maintain this. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam even prohibited those who are reading Quran to interfere with others who are either reading Quran or praying, let alone doing something that is not right. So be careful, dear brother. When you attend, turn off your phone. Don't look at it. Looking at it means that you are checking who has sent you an email, or who has sent you a text message, or who called you and missed your call. When we finish, then you are free to do whatever you want. By this, we maintain this atmosphere of the masjid, and also we teach our kids to respect and honor the masjid. When our kids see contradiction between our actions and statements, then we'll never be able to really effectively educate them. There are many other etiquettes for the masjid, but let us help one another to observe these few etiquettes, and let's remember that the masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was very clean, smells good, but it was very simple. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves our masjid to be simple. If you look about the masajid, If you examine, if you go back to history and check how the masajid was during the time of the first generation that established really the honor and the dignity for this deen, it was simple, very simple. But yet it was they were masajid pursuing a mission, and building generations. From whom the whole world benefited. There were saviors of the world, literally.